Welcome back to PSL Living. I'm Sarah Prohaska, Communications Manager here at the City of Port St. Lucie. The more you recycle in Port St. Lucie, the more you can do. And we are here, I'm welcoming Carmen Capezzuto, our Neighborhood Services Director, to talk about our NICE program and how it relates to recycling and everything that's happening with our Neighborhood Improvement and Community Engagement Program. Welcome, Carmen. Thank you so much. All right, so recycling, that is the basis of our NICE program, correct?
Yes, it is. The NICE program ties in with our Neighborhood Services Department, so it's part of that department. And our department, we also oversee solid waste. So we handle, you know, waste pro service needs in the community, and that's the tie-in for recycling. So the more you recycle, the more we can do out in the community to make our neighborhoods better. So it's a beautiful thing. Love to have as part of our program.
Yeah, and it ties in really nicely to the NICE program because that's basically what funds all your projects in that program. Yep. And I'm getting a little ahead, so if those of residents who are watching who might not know what NICE is, can you give us a little background?
Yeah, NICE is Neighborhood Improvement and Community Engagement. Mm-hmm. And so those are the two components of what we're trying to do here when City Council and staff embarked on neighborhood planning several years ago. Mm-hmm. Those are the two components. So you engage with the community and then you make those improvements that the residents are asking for. So that's what we're all about. We're about just trying to make our large city broke up into smaller, manageable chunks and show noticeable neighborhood improvements throughout.
Right. So one of your big projects last year was to give every neighborhood in the city a name because, you know, Port St. Lucie was originally developed in the 60s by a GDC, a developer, didn't really think about neighborhood names and community identities within these neighborhoods. So your big initiative last year was just to give every neighborhood a name, and the names were picked by residents through a big survey process we did. So that was, so the names are, they were proposed by residents in the community and they were voted on by residents in the community.
Correct, yeah. And so one of the big things that is, you know, we went through that campaign and now we have to take the next step.
Yes.
Because sadly, even I don't know where all of them are right now. I can tell you that I recognize the names, but if you said exactly where is this, where are the boundaries? Yeah. So that's our next 2 years. We're focusing on neighborhood signage, gateway features, so that when you're driving around, you can notice, you know where you're at now.
All right.
Rather than just looking at a map.
Exactly.
So that is the next step that we're working on, yes.
Okay, so I drive every morning to get to work. I drive through the very first neighborhood that was named in Port St. Lucie through the NICE program, which is Canal Point.
Yes.
Already in Canal Point, which is between South Bend and Port St. Lucie Boulevard, I would say. You know, east of the Turnpike and west of the river. So that little area right there generally is Canal Point. I have noticed new street signs that have gone up in there. Right. There is a new sidewalk being laid. That's all thanks to the NICE program, right?
Yeah. Yes and no. So, the street poles are funded through the recycling dollars. They're black, fluted, decorative poles with stop signs and large street names on them. So, yeah, those really, really make a difference when you're driving through. And then the sidewalk is funded through the Community Development Block Grant.
Oh, that's right.
Or CDBG.
That's right.
Which also runs through the Neighborhood Services Department. So that project is being managed by the Public Works Department. They recently broke ground on it, and it's on schedule to be finished by January of 2019, early January. So it'll be like a New Year sidewalk for the community. So yeah, things are starting to come together. Once all that's done, and then the welcome signs go in for Canal Point, hopefully very soon.
That's
our demonstration project. That's our pilot program to show residents what they can really do with this recycling money. And then just to plug, if I can, for litter. Once that sidewalk is in, I want to see somebody come through, keep Port St. Lucie Beautiful, which is in Public Works, and adopt that road. That would be a perfect road for someone to adopt, nice and safe with the sidewalk.
There you go. Yes. So maybe someone we meet through the NICE program will be willing to take that on, take on Adopt a Street.
Yep.
So, and you said welcome signs. These are basically neighborhood identity signs that'll say Canal Point, right?
Exactly. Okay. Yes. So we're doing a survey right now because we're very big on public input and community engagement. That's the essence of the program. So we have a survey out right now for Canal Point and Woodland Trails, just kind of finalizing the look and the feel of the signs. So we're going to take everyone's input. see what the consensus is, and then ultimately make a decision as to what type of sign goes in on each of our two locations and the color scheme. So okay. We're working all of that right now. Check your email for that survey.
Yes.
If you didn't get the survey, go online and take the survey, mm-hmm. and also give us your email so that we can email you through. I believe it's called Constant Contact.
Yes.
We can stay in touch. We want to get something out there to each community at least once a month, just to kind of stay in touch with everybody, keep that two-way street of communication going.
Right. So if you go to www.cityofpsl.com/nice, mm-hmm. you can find your neighborhood, and right there you can give us your email right mm-hmm. there, and then you'll be on an email list for your neighborhood.
Right.
So we can communicate directly with you. It's a way that you can communicate mm-hmm. directly back with us, mm-hmm. and you can get news tailored directly to mm-hmm. your neighborhood. So when it's time for your neighborhood to take the survey, it'll be sent to that to that neighborhood group.
And the really cool thing about that, Sarah, is mm-hmm. A lot of times that people have just a simple request.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, a lot of people walk their dog on the street. Can we get a dog waste station installed, mm-hmm. or can mm-hmm. we have a garbage can installed? Those are really simple things we can do, makes people happy, and it's not a whole lot of work that has mm-hmm. to go into that. Really cool to be able to offer that service back to people when we can just make their day just by they send us a request, and it may take a couple months or longer, uh-huh. but when we get it in, it's that was all generated at the neighborhood level. Really great stuff.
It is awesome. So there, definitely give us your email, because we may be having neighborhood meetings, neighborhood get-togethers.
Right,
that's a good way to learn about those.
I'm glad you mentioned that. Yes, uh-huh. on the survey, so mm-hmm. we're asking people, in addition to for feedback about the signs,
mm-hmm.
We're asking what their preferred projects would be when we get to you.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're also asking who would be interested in a neighborhood meeting.
Okay.
And so we're really trying to figure out who the leaders of each community mm-hmm. are going to be, who's going to step up and kind of take a leadership role
mm-hmm.
so that we can start communicating with the community on a larger level. That was kind of the impetus of why we needed this, was we wanted neighborhoods to be able to speak in larger volumes.
Yes.
So we have tools for people to form mm-hmm. civic associations, mm-hmm. or we're going to build like a neighborhood toolkit.
Okay.
If residents don't want to go too formal, we can have focus groups, do all kinds of great things, mm-hmm. but it requires the residents to raise their hand and step forward.
And to participate and have a say in where you live, right?
Absolutely.
So the other... So I just wanted to mention a few other things. We talk about recycling money.
Mm-hmm.
With the NICE program is funded by recycling money, but the recycling money is doing all kinds of cool things throughout the city, like our traffic wraps, our traffic cabinet wraps, mm-hmm. which you see popping up all around town, and now even has local artists have contributed to those wraps, so we're showing off the artwork of local artists.
Mm-hmm.
Those cool bike racks that you might have seen throughout town that are shaped like fish, and that's all recycling money. You're making little pocket parks where you would have goes into a pocket park, a bench, a bike rack, a pet station.
Little amenities that make the space more usable.
Mm-hmm.
I mentioned simple little things that people have requested. People have requested a bike rack because there's a bus stop there.
Mm-hmm.
And kids have to chain their bike to a tree or to a stop mm-hmm. sign or a speed limit sign or something like that. So it's those little improvements that make a big difference.
Yeah, and you can do fun things with them too. That kind of gives them character.
With the wraps, we're trying to do art in public places.
Yeah.
So we've taken that now and roll that into the bike racks. So
mm-hmm.
we have bike racks that are looking like fish,
or
squirrels, or whatever. So we kind of want to just bring more value mm-hmm. and interest to the community and do things a little bit different that people appreciate.
And then one of the biggest projects that recycling funds has paid for so far is the Woodland Trails Park, which is opened in the Woodland Trails neighborhood.
Mm-hmm.
I would say majority of that park was paid for with recycling funds.
Yes, it was.
And just a great way to show that if you're recycling, this is some of the really cool stuff we could do with the money that we get back.
Yeah, so we completed Parks and Rec. Mm-hmm. Parks and Recreation Department completed the construction of Woodland Trails Park in,
mm-hmm.
was it May, I believe, or June? I think it was June.
It was June.
The grand opening.
Yeah.
So we don't open too many parks in the city because they're expensive.
Mm-hmm.
However, when you open a park in the summertime, you learn it's hot.
It's very hot.
So we're trying to bring in shade in the form of trees or some other shade structures to kind of make that a little bit more user-friendly in the summertime.
Yeah.
I did go there with my son, and like I saw firsthand just how hot it can be.
It can be hot in the summer, but luckily once fall comes around, then we should be good.
Yeah, luckily we have water fountains there for everyone to cool down a little bit.
And there's a dog park there, so you got water fountains for the dogs too there.
Yeah. So we took a neighborhood park and multi-purposed it, brought a dog park in as a component. Mm-hmm. Now we have a western dog park to go with our eastern dog park at Lingate.
Exactly.
So, lots happening. It's all taking shape, and it's just, it's going to take time because it's a big city and we've got a lot of ground to cover.
Exactly. So I know coming up on September 27th, the city is partnering with the county in Fort Pierce to hold an open house regarding the proposed half-cent sales tax that will be on the November 6th ballot. The NICE money and sales tax money don't have anything to do with each other, but right. NICE is taking, it's a chance to meet residents. Mm-hmm. So you will be at that open house, correct?
Yes.
With a NICE table.
Yep.
Just to talk to residents, maybe gather input.
Yeah, we look for every opportunity to communicate with the residents, and we used the constant contact email database for those residents that gave us their email to send them a special invitation. So that's a glimpse of what you'll get. You'll get special invites to certain things that where we're going to be at. So you can come out and talk to us about how maybe some of these projects will benefit your neighborhood.
Yeah.
Maybe if a project doesn't qualify under the sales tax plan, maybe it's something that we can do with long-term planning.
Exactly.
So, it's every opportunity to communicate with people. We're going to be there, and we hope everyone comes out, too. Even if you didn't get that special invitation, still want everyone watching the show to come out and see what we have to talk about.
So that will be between 5 and 8. It's going to be drop-in, so come in anytime between 5 and 8 on September 27th. Got some time to put that on your calendar. So.
Yep, and if you missed that one, we'll start very soon having regular neighborhood meetings. Mm-hmm. We've got over 27 or 28 different areas or neighborhoods in the city, so it's a lot to have them one-on-one. So we're looking at grouping certain neighborhoods together and having possibly on a quarterly basis, in addition to our annual events.
Yeah, I was going to say, you have your annual NICE day.
So we're looking to have, at least quarterly neighborhood meetings to start. Like I said, see who raises their hand, see who comes forward and is serious about engaging with us in long-term planning, and then we'll go from there.
Great. All right, Carmen, thanks so much for coming in and giving us an update. We haven't talked about NICE in a while, so it's good to see you again.
It was nice to talk about NICE.
All right, very good, and nice work. All right, thanks so much, and we will be right back after these messages.